Hey everybody, how are you? This is John from the Goo Goo Dolls, and we have a special pandemic edition of Behind Mike, and I'm going to answer some questions about some songs, play some tunes for you all. I'd like to give a big shout out to my good friend Rob Dye. Thank you so much, Rob. You've been a fan of the band and a friend of the band, and you know, for many years, and thank you for all your support. And thank American Songwriter for all their support. And yeah, so let's get to it. I'm gonna answer some questions. They want to know about song Miracle Pill. What stood out about this song that made you release it as a single and be the album's title track? Well, Miracle Pill, that just sounds like an amazing title for an album. When Sam Hollander, who's a great songwriter, he and I got together, it was just this instant energy between us. And man, when I heard what he was doing, you know, and we merged all of our ideas together, it was just this great thing. It was just so immediate. The immediacy of the song was just so great. What was the songwriting process like for this song? Well, like I said, you know, I came in and I was like, bada bit, bada boo, 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 da boo, boo, bada ba 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 da doo doo doo. And Sam started working on some different melodic lines, and we were just busting out lyrics back and forth with each other. It was a lot of fun. You know, Sam Hollander is a really, he's a fun guy to write with. You know, he reminds me a lot of you know, guys like Greg Wattenberg that have collaborated in the past, where you're just having so much fun that you don't even realize you're working. And that's kind of the way I think the best material comes out. You know, who broke the code? Definitely Sam broke the code on that one. Cause he's just got this insane creative mind, and it came in with an idea and he just went boom out of nowhere. And then it became something else, and it was fantastic. And, let's see. What about the Dizzy Up the Girl 20th anniversary tour made you want to get back in the studio so quick? Because the Dizzy Up the Girl tour, the 20th anniversary, even though it was really cool to do it, it made me realize that I have to keep moving forward, and I can't rely solely on what I've done in the past, and I just got to get music going as fast as possible. And keep moving forward. You know, that's really what it's all about. It's just keeping music out there as much as possible, because, you know, I still feel like I got something to say.
Hi, Lily. What are you doing?
Ouch, did you bonk your head? Oh, okay, that's my little girl. She bonked her head. All right, so we're gonna do Miracle Pill. What I need is a true love chemical. I want to beat like a heart that's painted in gold. Here we go. I want to make these emotions physical. Free the weight of my soul ethereal. I believe I'm alive, no higher than low. Here we go. So baby, would you be my miracle pill? Yeah, I could be somebody else. So sick. Myself, it's all of my life, all of my doubt, all of my upkeep, beating me down. Started all over. All of my fight, all of my fear, all of my darkness, leading me in. Started all over. Wanna feel like the new world's crumbling. Wanna feel all my walls come tumbling. I wanna keep that fire burning, you know. Here we go, baby. Would you be my miracle pill? Yeah, I could be somebody else. So sick of living inside myself. All of my life, all of my doubt, all of my upkeep, keeping me down. started on low, started on low, started on low. All of my fight, all of my fear, all of my darkness leave me here. Started on low, started on low, started on low. How long's it gonna take? How long before you how long it gonna take? How long before you feeling? What I need is being incredible. What I need is true love edible. I wanna beat like a heart that's beating in gold. Here we go. All of my life, all of my doubt, all of my upkeep keeping me down. Started our love, started our love, started our love. All of my fight, all of my fear, all of my darkness keep me here. Started our love, started our love, started our love. All right, cool. So that's Miracle Pill. Slight variation on the end there because I screwed it up. Okay. Let's see. So the next song is So Alive. And the first question is, how do you keep up with songwriting while on a major tour? And unfortunately, the truth is I don't. I'll just collect little bits of ideas, maybe at a sound check or hum something into the phone, but I used to take time off after the tour, and now I don't do that. I just try to get back in the studio and writing as quickly as possible because the world is moving so much faster. And when you write your own songs, you're in a strange position because, yeah, I mean, you can't compete with these mega, you know, sort of pop star factories that are pumping music out. There's writers all over the world writing for certain artists, and I mean, you can't keep up with that. So I'm just trying to reduce the amount of time that I keep putting material out, because that seems to be the way of the world. The key to that is just getting back in the studio. And collaboration helps a lot. Getting together with a guy like Greg Wattenberg or Derek Furman, Alex Aldi, you know, Drew Pearson. You know, there's just so many good guys out there that I love writing with, and they teach me things. You know, I learn from those guys, and that makes it a lot of fun. Because I like learning as much as I can. So let's check out the next song. Which song is that? So Alive? No, I just did So Alive. I didn't? Oh, yeah, right. No, wait, Sympathy is the next one. Oh, no, wait, you're right. Sorry. Sorry about this. Okay, So Alive. Yeah. So this song is a kind of a song about sort of facing everything that you're afraid of, and then realizing that it's going to be okay. It's definitely a song about, it's been interpreted as a song about getting sober and facing the truth about yourself, you know, which, yeah, it probably is. Yeah. So, this is called So Alive. Feel me like a hero, but I can't fly. No, you never crash if you don't try. Took it to the edge, now I know why. Never gonna live if you're too scared to die. Gonna disconnect from the hard wire. Time to raise a flag for the ceasefire. Staring down the hole inside me. gonna wish if you want to. I'm so alive, so alive, so alive. Yeah, you can make it on a wish if you want to. You can make it on a wish if you want to. Open up the heart like a shotgun, blinded by the light of a new sun. Get up, get out, and get done. For the first time, I feel like someone. Breaking down the walls in my own mind. Keeping my faith for that time. Get up, stand like a champion. Come on, sing it like an anthem. I'm so alive, so alive, so alive, yeah. You can make it on a wish if you want to. You can make it on a wish if you want to. I'm so alive, so alive, so alive, yeah. You can make it on a wish if you want to. You can make it on a wish if you want to. Now I am no man of steel. I have no heart of stone, so don't tell me how it feels, 'cause I found you on my own. Hey, yeah. Never gonna live if you're too scared to die. I'm so alive, so alive, so alive. Yeah, you can make it on a wish if you want to. I'm so alive, so alive, so alive. Yeah, you can make it on a wish if you want to. You can make it on a wish if you want to. Yeah. Okay, I threw a bonus note in there for you guys, which, you know, some people call a mistake, but I think it's a bonus. I never said I was a great guitar player. excuse me. Yeah, no, I'm not a great guitar player, but I still enjoy doing it. And I guess one of the things I never really studied guitar and kind of made up a lot of my own tunings to play it using capos. And that's why when people come to see us play, there's always like 35 guitars on the side of the stage because I need to change guitars a lot to get the tunings correct. And I think you can find them online. I'm going to post them on our website so that way you know you get the real ones. And, you know, and if anybody has any suggestions about how to play them easier, let me know. So we'll figure this out. This is an older song, and it's called Sympathy. And the song is actually about kind of being, this sort of is the prequel to So Alive, because this song was sort of written at a time where it was just, I was in a pretty dark place, pretty scary place, where I was just trying to, you know, kick some bad habits, and I couldn't. It was incredibly difficult. You know, and I've been lucky because I haven't had to have a drink in 5 years. So I appreciate all the help that everybody's given me with that. But that's just a little background on the song. And so some questions about it are: who's been the most influential person, people in your careers? Most influential person, people in my career. I think my manager has influenced me as far as developing a really good work ethic. And Robbie's been a big influence in the same way. You know, he'll kick me in the ass when I need to get something done. You know, he's the eternal optimist. He's sure that everything's going to be all right. And I'm the guy that's going, oh my God, the sky's falling. You know, Rob Cavallo was a huge influence on us as being the first real producer that we worked with. You know, first major label producer guy that we worked with, and you know, he helped take the band to another level. He helped me realize that I could actually write better songs, you know. And here's the thing, you know, and all the songwriters out there, it's like, it's not always the most commercially successful song that's the best song, because I grew up listening to bands like, you know, The Replacements and Husker Du and Soul Asylum. And I mean, you know, they're all sort of contemporaries of ours. They're always a couple of years ahead of us on what was going on. And, you know, I was also influenced by a lot of music from the UK, my high school years, you know, things like Echo and the Bunnymen, a lot of post-punk stuff, and The Clash. And, you know, yeah, those people were really influential. Their music changed my life and changed my worldview in a lot of ways. You know, I'm really, especially a guy like Bob Mould, whose lyrics are just incredible, and sometimes they're gut-wrenching, and sometimes they're so incredibly like joyous, and but there's always this little bit of sadness and darkness in the background, and I love that. I love that. Yeah. What is the best advice that they've ever given you? Okay, best advice they ever gave us was, my manager ever gave me, was when we finally got a hit on our fifth album, which was a song called Name. He said, keep your head down and just keep working. And so, you know, it's 25 years later, and we're still pounding as hard as we can, you know? What advice would you give to aspiring songwriters? Okay, I don't give my advice to aspiring songwriters unless they ask me for it. So since you've asked me for it, I'm going to give it to you. Work as hard as you can to find your own voice. Obviously, we all start working through our influences, and then we need the time to develop ourselves and find our own voice. You know, there's nothing new under the sun at all. And, but there are different ways to twist it up and make it your own. Put your own spin on it. Try to develop your own voice. Forget about being a rock star. It's, you know, that's not the important thing. The important thing is that you're writing songs. And like, what are the metrics that you use to consider what you're doing good? Do you like it? Does your girlfriend like it? I mean, is it a top 10 hit on the radio? Who knows? I just think you have to walk away from the situation being proud of what you did. And then you've succeeded. And the rest of it's out of your control anyway, because once you put a song out in the world, you have no control over what happens to it. And believe me, I've tried to control over what happens to it. But you just gotta find your own voice, do your own thing. Don't worry about money, fame, and fortune. It'll come if it's supposed to. And if it's not, you still got a great gift that you can share with people any way you want. All right, enough lecturing. I'm gonna grab a drink of water here and go into this. So like I said, this song is called Sympathy. And to me, So Alive, the last song, So Alive, and Sympathy, the lyrics are very important to pay attention to. Because although they leave a little room for interpretation, it's pretty obvious what, you know, what they're about. Don't set me free. It's all I wanted. I get scared, but I'm not crawling on my knees. all the air. Everything's all wrong here. Everything's all wrong here. Where the hell did I think I was? Stranger than your sympathy. Take these things so I don't feel. Killing myself from the inside out. Now my head's been filled with doubt. Cause it's hard to be the life you choose. It's all I wanted. All your luck's run out on you. It's all I wanted. But you can't see when all your dreams are coming true. Oh, yeah, it's easy to forget, yeah. Till you choke on your regrets, yeah. Who the hell did I think I was? Stranger than your sympathy. All this time you stole from me. I'm not sure where I belong. Nowhere's home, I'm all wrong. And I wasn't all the things I tried to make believe I was. And I wouldn't be the one to kneel before the dreams I wanted. But all the talk, all the lies, were all the empty things disguised as me.
Actually made it through without screwing it up.
Oh!
Alright. Once again, I want to thank everybody at American Songwriter and Rob Dye especially, you know, for supporting our music, our band, for a long time. And, you know, everybody just needs to stay safe, stay in place. We're all going to get through this, and then we'll get back out next summer. You know, so this next song is called Broadway, and the questions here are, how has the band's songwriting evolved since this album in 1998? Well, I don't know, but it's like every time I go into the studio, I don't want to repeat myself, you know, so sometimes I'll, you know, play with strings or, you know, try different sounds or use keyboards, or use drum machines, do whatever. Just to try and freshen it up, expand it, go to another place. I don't want to be limited by, you know, I don't want to have to try and write another Iris, because that's just not going to happen. I've learned a lot more about engineering and production, which has been great, which is sort of, because being able to be in the studio and understand how to get a certain sound, how to mangle sound is really cool. That's really important. And to me, it's just another instrument that can be played, you know, and if you record something a certain way, it can inspire so much, and it can touch a lot of people if you do it the right way. Not saying I have, but I mean, occasionally I have, but, you know, I'm getting a lot more hands-on and with it. I work with a great engineer that I love, and, Brad and Jimmy, who play in the band, Craig, you know, they're great in the studio too, you know, because there's just such great over the top trained musicians, and I have no training. So it's nice that they can speak a more technical musical language. But, you know, me, I like to get down and dirty. I want to distort everything and, you know, run things through things that you're not supposed to do. And for me, that kind of exploration inspires more creativity. What is it like to see fans still loving your songs you wrote over 20 years ago? you know what? It's really gratifying that those songs have been able to hold up, and it's gratifying. I feel grateful, you know. It's like everybody's like, "Ah, you sick of playing Iris?" No, because that song changed my life, and you know, songs like "Name" and "Iris" and "Broadway" and "Slide," you know, "Better Days," things like that. Those songs have they've given me a life and a career, and you know, when I get out in front of people, it's like I want to entertain people, you know. That's because, you know, people spend a lot of money on concert tickets. It ain't cheap to come out to a show, and you got to give people what they want, you know. And I don't choose my audience, and I understand my obligation to the people who support us. So, you know, and that's that always kind of pissed me off about guys and bands who didn't want to play their big hit because they were sick of it. And I felt like, wow, that's so arrogant and self-indulgent. You know, it's like, if you look at yourself as being, you know, with the audience and of service in a way to them, you know, because if you really kind of break it down, when you go out touring, you know, it's a service industry. You're there to put on a show, and you know, people don't want to hear your jazz exploration, unless of course you're into jazz or whatever. But you know, a band like us, people want to hear those songs. Those songs mark time in people's lives, and people have a strong connection to them, and they've grown up with us, you know. So, you know, I love sharing that with them. So, enough lecturing. Again, I've been stuck in the house for a while, so I'm starting to go a little nuts. This song's Broadway. Excuse me. And I wrote this song about the neighborhood I grew up in, which is very, very sort of working class, you know, lower class, working class kind of neighborhood. And I didn't write this until I had enough time and space away from the people that I grew up with in the neighborhood. And you know, I mean, it was a tough place to grow up. You know, it was a neighborhood full of tough guys, and I was not a tough guy. I got four sisters, but you know, it was a different time and a different place, and there was a strange kind of darkness about that place. But there was also a lot of good, and the more distance I have from it, you know, the better I feel about it. But so. I wrote this song called Broadway. It goes like this. Broadway is dark tonight. A little bit weaker than we used to be. Broadway is dark tonight. You may be watching me get coronavirus right now. Okay, here we go. Broadway's dark tonight. A little bit weaker than we used to be. Broadway's dark tonight. See the young man sitting in the old man's bar, waiting for his turn to die. Cowboy kills the rock star. Friday night's gone too far. The dim light hides the years on our faded girls. Forgotten but not gone. You drink your mind. You talk about the world like it's someplace that you've been. You see a love to run home. But you know we ain't got one. We're living in a world with the best folk all around. Yeah. Broadway's dark night.
start tonight. See the young man sitting in the old man's bar. Wedding buzz turned to night. Yeah. You choke down all your anger. Forget your only son. You pray the statues weigh your sober up for fun. Your anger down impressed me. The world slapped me in your face. It always brings like hell on a loser's day. See a loved one coming, but you know we ain't got one. We're living in a world that we're best for God. Think you're a joke, nobody's gonna listen to the one small point. I know you've been missing around me. Broadway's dark tonight. Broadway's dark tonight. See the young man sitting in the old man's bar, waiting for his turn to die. Got you the okay. I want to thank everybody for showing up. If you have any comments, questions, go to our socials and post them there. I'll try to answer as much as possible. Really appreciate it at American Songwriter. You guys have been great. Everybody at Taylor Guitars have been hooking me up with these great guitars to do these performances. And I want to thank my wife, who is now my producer, and BK, who is risking his life to come up here and help me get it together so we can do this for you guys. Always grateful to you. Thank you so much. Thanks again to Rob Dye. And stay safe. Bye.